today, even the least tech-savvy individuals can create an ERC-20 or BEP-20 token. You no longer need to write your own smart contract. On websites like pinksale.finance, you can mint a token with its unique characteristics. It's that simple. You can even create a liquidity pool for your newly minted asset if needed. It's all easy and can be achieved in a matter of seconds. But what if people only used personal or personalized tokens in day-to-day activities? Is it theoretically possible? If that is the case, what would we need to achieve this kind of financial future, and how would such a flow be structured? Let's talk about a hypothetical scenario that could happen in the far future, where people exchange goods or services using their own personal tokens exclusively. Without further ado, let's get rolling. If I have a token called Shark Numbers Token and you have a token called John Smith or Sandra Bryan's token or my best pet store token, we could theoretically exchange services using those assets. But how could we trade products and services with millions and billions of tokens without interrupting the process? If I have my token and I go to a place where no one knows my token, but I still want to complete a purchase using my asset, there needs to be an instant swapping system in place so that I can exchange my currency for another currency instantly with the lowest fees possible. So it's very much possible that future advancements or developments in the blockchain space could introduce additional layers beyond layer 3. These layers would likely build upon the existing infrastructure and aim to provide further scalability, functionality, and interoperability. To make the ecosystem functional, we would still need a medium of exchange, a universal stablecoin of sorts, and I spoke more about that in my previous video. Or alternatively, we could create an index of low inflation currencies and use it as a medium of exchange, which is theoretically possible too. Such an index could be used as a benchmark or reference point for pricing goods and services. Now, let's talk about liquidity. With millions of personal digital assets in circulation, there will need to be ways to incentivize market makers to engage in liquidity-related activities. For that, I could imagine individuals and companies creating advanced staking opportunities to attract investors. Not only that, with a number of rising cryptos, millions of new unique digital assets representing people and businesses, I can envision the rise of new financial instruments helping investors navigate through all the data. And these tools could be powered by AI. To get a sense of what the dynamics could look like, let's imagine a website like CoinMarketCap or CoinGecko, but on steroids. Powered by AI. A cryptocurrency data aggregator would track millions of digital assets and allow investors to filter out results by liquidity, trading volume, maturity of an asset, and performance of an actual person or business associated with that particular asset. To prevent scams, security measures or regulations of some sort could be introduced. It could be a form of digital identification, a form of a digital fingerprint that is exclusively associated with a particular creator. You have your social security now? Why not have something similar developed and introduced in the DeFi world? You have your credit score? Why not have something similar but in a decentralized finance world? If we associate a particular coin with a real person or a real business, in the case of a rug pull or another dishonest activity, aggregators would be able to send a signal to investors and authorities. This entire process could be automated. A bad actor would be naturally filtered out. It would be instantly identified and blacklisted. The ecosystem would take care of itself. AI could help crypto aggregators navigate through big data, breaking down complex observations into simple and clear bullet points. The new generation of aggregators would translate the reality of the finance world and show people the best possible investment opportunities as well as red flags associated with particular personal or personalized tokens. Now, how would governments be structured if we faced an inevitable shift and at some point in time the mentioned scenario takes place? First off, with a new universal medium of exchange, whether it's a universal stablecoin or an index of multiple currencies, there will be no single dominant form of money. So naturally, with this alone, there will be more power given to people and less power given to governments. Decentralization would likely introduce significant changes on a governmental level as well. Hypothetically, just hypothetically, we could see more independence between governmental agencies. We could see less centralization. Maybe there would even be custom coins created by each individual governmental agency. Why not? The IRS could, for example, have the IRS token, and the FBI could have the FBI token. The introduction of such changes would only add more transparency to how each agency performs. We could better track the financial operations of each individual agency, and taxpayers would better understand where the money goes. Speaking of taxes, with personal custom tokens, filing taxes would get a lot easier too. First off, all the transactions would be transparently displayed on the ledger. With new generation tax preparation software connected directly to the distributed ledger, filing taxes and verifying the validity of reports would require a minimum of time by humans. So it's very possible to decentralize this process and make it significantly smoother and cheaper. All in all, personal or personalized tokens could have tangible benefits in the future when decentralization takes place. Controlled decentralization in the finance sector, coupled with the idea of personal assets, would only make the finance sector fairer for all participants, boosting talent and creativity currently often muted or put on hold by discouraged players. Motivation naturally takes place when the game is fair for all. And this is exactly what decentralization and personal or personalized tokens can bring. Fairness, better resource allocation, and more talent. I'm done for today. If you enjoyed this video, then show your sign of appreciation. Join my Discord channel if you want to become a member of Shark Numbers. I'm done for now. I'll talk to you soon. Ivan KV out.